In this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to create a glitch text animation. Hi guys, my name is Manuel. I'm a freelance motion designer bringing you fresh animation and motion graphics tutorials every week. To follow along, you might want to download the project file. No time to lose, let's get started. We grab the type tool up here and add some text. I use Josephine Sans Bold, which is an Adobe font, size 170. Anyways, choose whatever font you want or your client requests. I would recommend something bold though. Neon glitch. Then we press this double T button here to make it all capitals. Let's align the text to the center of the solid. And let's align the solid to the center of the composition with the alignment tool. In this comp, there'll just be this text layer. You can change that content here anytime, even add a logo or icon instead, without affecting the setup, to which we'll get to now. We grab the text comp we just worked on and drag it down here onto this comp symbol, which creates a new comp and automatically adds the text comp. Let's name the new comp Glitch Animation. Let's add some effects to begin with. CC Scale Wipe is the first one. CC Scale Wipe basically stretches pixels, beginning from a center point into a certain direction. So let's stretch, maybe 1.8. We leave the center point in the center and set the direction to 90 degrees. Let's stretch the other side of the text as well, by simply duplicating the effect and changing the direction to minus 90 degrees. Now let's add Venetian blinds. This is a transition effect, but we're actually going to use it to add some more detail. We set the transition completion to 20%, the direction to 90 degrees, and the width to 20. Which adds some nice thin lines. Now we've got this weirdly stretched type. Maybe we leave it as it is and create a new comp, command or control N. Let's name it texture, 1920 by 1080, 90 frames long. All right, let's add a solid, command Y, color doesn't matter. And to this solid, we add the turbulent noise effect to create a, like the comp name suggests, texture. Set the fractal type to basic, the noise type to block, contrast 100, let's open transform and deactivate uniform scaling. Set scale width to 200 and scale height to 10. To have some movement in the texture, let's set a keyframe for the evolution. Let's open it up in the effects property down in the timeline. Now we hold option while clicking on the little stopwatch again, which opens the expression field. We're going to use the time expression. Type in time and semicolon. This tells After Effects to change the evolution by 1 degree every second. Not really impressive. So we multiply that by 500, inserting little star and 500 between time and the semicolon. Much more interesting. Now there's some stuff going on. Anyways, let's go back to our glitch animation comp and add the texture comp on top. Let's hide it for now. If you like what you see, please leave a like and subscribe to my channel. That would mean a lot. Thanks so much. And add a displacement map to the text comp. The displacement map takes the luminance information from, let's choose the texture comp, and based on that displaces the position of pixels. I guess the time has come to finally animate some stuff. We select the text comp and add keyframes for the two center points and the max horizontal displacement by clicking on these little stopwatches. Then we press U to show the properties in the timeline and set the displacement to 900. Then we go to 10 frames and move the upper center point to the right edge of the screen. 1920. And the lower center point to 0. The left edge. This unstretches the text. And we set displacement to 10 so that the text is readable. Then we go to 50 frames, click on these three squares to add keyframes. One frame later, we stretch the type again. Even more than the first time. And two frames later, we reduce the stretch again. And we set the displacement to something high, like 1800. Finally, we press Shift T to add the opacity property. Set a keyframe, and one frame later, set it to 0 to hide it. Alright. At least it starts to look like a text animation. Let's open the texture comp and add posterized time. And set the frame rate to 10. Going back to the main comp, the movement isn't that fluent anymore, which I think fits better to glitch. Let's animate the displacement a bit more. We go to frame 1 and increase the displacement even more to around 2500. Then one frame later, we decrease it to 20. One more frame later, we increase it again to 500. Here it's all about contrast. The more difference in the values, the clearer the animation. We should add some more details though. Let's go to 30 frames, set a keyframe. Then at 31 frames, we set it to around 65. And two frames later, to around 5. Then we go to 40 frames, set a keyframe, and one frame later, change it to 15. Then to 10. Alright, it looks much less static now in the middle part. Nice. Time for, some might say, a cheap trick. We duplicate the comp 2 times, Command D. Grab the rectangle tool and add a mask to each of them, revealing a different part of the text. The top, the middle, and the lower third. They can overlap slightly, just make sure to not spare a part of your content. Now the trick. We offset the comps. The animation begins with the middle part. 3 frames later, the lower part comes in. 3 more frames later, the upper part. And check out what happened. There's so much more going on just by offsetting the animations a little bit. Love it. Let's add some color, right? We make the texture comp visible and activate preserve transparency. The texture is visible on the text, but the transparent background is preserved. Very convenient. Anyways, let's add a tritone effect and change the colors in whatever you like. I go for pink highlights, yellow midtones, and blue shadows. Too much yellow for my taste. We need to adjust the contrast and brightness of the texture a little until it looks how we want it to look like. One last thing. This works well with a transparent background, but as soon as you add a solid, it's messed up, of course. So we take the glitch animation, drag it on the comp symbol, and now it works. I'd keep the background dark though. Finally, let's add a glow to the glitch animation. Threshold 100%, radius 50, intensity maybe 2. But that's very much up to your taste. On the left side, I've added some videos you might like, so see you there. Subscribe to my channel on the right side and ring the bell if you want to know exactly when the next video is coming out. Thanks so much for watching. Hope that tutorial was useful for y'all. See you in the next video. Bye!